And it was a horrific crime that made national news, but finally federal prosecutors tell Channel 11 News that the accused John Chapman will go on trial in April of 2023. Chapman is charged with driving a Pennsylvania woman to Nevada on a house hunting trip and then suffocating her.
And our reporter Amy Hudak has been following this case for the last 3 years, and she's here tonight with more.
The feds tell me John Chapman could face the death penalty if he's convicted. And as his trial approaches, the impact and trauma caused by the death of Jamie Fedden reveals its heavy cost, because some say there was a price to pay for knowing John Chapman. If you asked John Chapman, he would probably say he believes in love.
I believed him.
Just ask Maureen.
I believed every word he ever told me.
She says Chapman was so convincing.
Every word about his job and the CIA.
She soon became his fourth wife.
I had no reason not to believe him, and especially as his wife.
Until one morning, she got a phone call.
And he said, "Hun, I murdered a woman because I had to." I said, "What?"
And it all crumbled apart. In Vegas. Chapman told his wife government training had brought him there, when in fact he had traveled there with this woman, Jamie Fedden from Bethel Park, his girlfriend on the side, until she just vanished. 2 months later, deep in the Nevada desert, a father and son discovered Jamie's body.
I remember her feet being so small. That's one thing that caught my eyes, was her feet and her hands. Just a lonely soul in the middle of a vast desert.
I want people to know that he is a manipulator. He's a liar.
And for Kelly Murray,
your head must have spun.
You know what? It did. It was horrible.
The news hit really close to home.
And I think the thought that it could have been me, I think I got a little bit sick over it.
Not only did she know Jamie Fedden, she was once Chapman's second wife.
He's like, "I want to get married." Okay.
And where was the ceremony?
Vegas. We went to the stained glass wedding chapel.
But then fate stepped in.
I'm glad I got away from him.
And as for Maureen, as Chapman's trial approaches,
I wake up every morning just telling myself I can and I will keep going.
Maureen says it's difficult as details of what happened leak out.
He used Jamie so much.
But she also reminds herself.
You know, I wasn't the true victim here. Jamie was.
Amy Hudak, Channel 11 News.
All right, Amy, thank you.